Hello, Duke of the Bump here, and this is not Buzz and Waldog. This is, as you can see, the Legend of the Mystical Ninja. Now you may be wondering why I'm putting Buzz and Waldog on hold after just one video, you know, one extra long video, but one video nevertheless. Hey kitty, have you heard the news?
What are you talking about?
You know, about that beautiful girl.
Oh, you mean the ghost woman of the temple.
Yeah, that's the one. Something terrible has happened. Zoom in on your eyes.
Oh no! Hey, no close-ups! That's no way for a good ghost to act. She shouldn't hurt people. That ghost has some nerve.
I'll show her that I'm a brave man.
Talk is cheap. Let's go. I'm with you, Dr. Yang.
Okay. This is actually a request from a friend. And I know what you're going to say. You're going to say, but Duke, how come you never did my request? I thought you didn't do requests. You always said no requests, blah blah blah. Well, this is kind of a special situation. The person who requested this is a good friend of mine who's in the army. I will mention his name to protect his anonymity. And he's actually currently stationed in Iraq. He's the one who actually turned me on to this game to begin with. If you're lucky, you may have caught me streaming this with Moors quite a few months back. We weren't very good at it, but hopefully, you know, I'll do a little better this time. And, yeah, he requested that I LP this game. He requested that I be tipsy when I do it. So I've been drinking spirits of an alcoholic nature. You know, not enough to really affect me, just enough to loosen the tongue, so to speak. Now, I'm not really a fan of the Iraq War. You could say that I hate it. I wish we weren't in the country. I'm not interested in that. But I know that my friend, he's not one of the typical, well, I shouldn't say typical because that's a stereotype, but he's not one of those warmongering types. I know he doesn't want to be there any more than I want the U.S. to be in Iraq. So, he's going to be stationed there for at least the next year or so, I think, possibly longer. I'm hoping shorter. You know, now that there's this big push by the politicians to pull out of Afghanistan, I'm hoping that'll lead to an early withdrawal from Iraq. Wait, was that a game or was it just some dude talking? But yeah, I'm doing this request because he's in Iraq and it's horrible over there. I mean, you know, not that Iraq is a horrible country, you know, it has its pluses and its minuses, but being in the army in Iraq and the US soldier, oh, the maze is too dangerous for me to go in. Being a U.S. soldier in Iraq has got to be not a very good situation. And so yeah, that's why. If you don't like it, then join the army and go to Iraq, and I will do your request. And if there are any current vets, or not vets, but you know, any current troops watching this, you know, I kind of doubt it, but if so, send me a message and I will do a request. Anything I'm capable of. And this is the, as far as I know, is the only appearance of testicles in any Super Nintendo game ever on the Tanuki. I mean, at first, if you just look at it, it just looks like, you know, something carved out of a tree, and maybe that's part of the tree stump. But no, it's balls. So, that's interesting. As far as I know, this game was rated, let's see, this is a pretty old game, so I think the ratings used, well, I know they had ratings on Genesis games back then. And on a Genesis, it would have been GA for general audiences. I don't know if that was actually the ESRB or not. I don't think the ESRB even existed back then. Because this was like 92 or 93. And of course later, well, when the ESRB first materialized, the rating would have been KA, or K to A, for kids to adults. And of course, the modern rating that we all know is E for everyone. But on the Super Nintendo, I'm not 100% sure if they had ratings back then. Because I think the Genesis just had like an independent rating system that, you know, they used before the ESRB came around. But anyway, this game was definitely, you know, marketed to kids. So the fact that it has balls in it is pretty amusing. So this game, known as, I think it was Goemon or something like that, in Japan, this was the first Goemon game, I believe. There was later a sequel on the N64. When we were playing two players, you know, we had both Kid Ying and Dr. Yang, we made it. We actually made it pretty far. I mean, it took us forever. And we kept dying a lot. Now, I haven't really been getting any power-ups or anything so far. I mean, I got an extension in my staff once. There's another one, and I missed it. But I haven't been buying any sandals or protective gear or anything like that. So, you know, I'm pretty vulnerable right now. Hopefully, I was practicing a little bit earlier before I actually started this LP, and I was doing pretty well. I didn't die on the stage last time, but I started drinking and I'm talking, so I'm not really paying as close attention. I don't think I'll be dying too terribly much. Oh, crap. If I keep doing that, I will. Are these things mushrooms or umbrellas? They look kind of like both. I forget what the scrolls are for. If you hit select, you can bring up the screen that shows your equipment. Right now, just the very bare essentials. And you can use L and R to switch to projectile attack. Damn it, I died right before the checkpoint, too. The scrolls, I think, there's some sort of, like, they power up your attack or something like that? I don't know. I brought up a screen with scrolls on it somehow. Oh, there we go. Start. Yeah, I have two scrolls, but I forget how to use them. Or what they're for. Oh, yeah. I love the 2D platforming sequences of this game, because you can do the worm. It's pretty cute. This whole game is cute. It's downright adorable, if I do say so myself. Alright, this is the first boss. I'm low on health, but I should be able to take care of her without too many issues. All you have to do, really, is stand in a corner, and then when a plate comes near you, just smack it. You don't really have to aim or anything. Oh, fudge. Of course. Raccoon dog. interesting that this game came after the Tanuki suit in Super Mario Bros. 3. But they still didn't feel comfortable calling it a tanuki, so raccoon dog it is. At least I still have my money. Oops. Oh yeah, you have to use the R button to switch weapons. For some reason the L button doesn't do it. I mean, you think they would just, you know, cycle back and forth, but I don't know, maybe the L button's for something else. So, yeah, I apologize for going so long without another video. I kinda don't have many opportunities to record right now, because at my new job, I have to be in bed super early, because I have to get up at 5, I have to be at work at 7, and of course, have to, you know, take a shower, and there's a commute, so I'm supposed to go to bed. Well, I'd like to go to bed at 9 every night, but that doesn't usually end up happening. But either way, I just don't really have time to record during the week. And on the weekend, I usually, you know... Oh wait, there's a cutscene coming up, so... Oh my, you're so strong. I'm the Ninja Cat Kurobe. I've been waiting for someone to help me out of here. There's no time to explain. Take this $100 and hurry to Shikoku Island. Go see the cat boss, Koban. Ninja Cat out. You know, I don't know if that guy can be trusted. I mean, I just met the dude. But he did give me $100, so... Anybody who gives me $100 has got to be a pretty good person. Oh, and also, give me $100 and I'll do your request then as well. What was I saying? Oh yeah. See, I don't really like recording when my housemates are up because... I don't know, I'm weird. I get uncomfortable if I'm talking and... there's a chance that someone might walk in on me. You know, I won't hear them, and I'll get all startled, and they'll break my concentration, and just all kinds of problems. So yeah, I'd rather record after they go to bed, but you know, I have to wait until pretty late to do that, which is why there aren't many videos. But I'll try to do better in the future, you know. Usually, my Friday nights are free, so maybe I should start recording then. Alright, I'm gonna drink some more alcohol. Hold on one sec. In case you're wondering, that's, Southern Comfort and Coke. Okay, this is a secret mate. Oh, don't leave. Go back. This is a secret maze. You know, it doesn't look that secret. I mean, it's kinda out there right in the open. You may get lost inside, but there are many treasures to be found. It costs $100 to search. What do you think? I'm pretty flush right now, so I'll go for it. It's a good deal. There's well over $100 worth of stuff in here. Okay, you can use the A button to bring up this map, which is extremely helpful because everything looks alike in here, so it's very easy to get lost. You can also find a map that'll show all of the paths, and basically, oh, there it is. See, that shows every way you can go, so basically you don't even have to worry about getting lost. You know, it'll just take slightly longer than normal because you have to keep checking the map. Oops, that's the exit. I don't want to go there yet. But, you know. Basically what I'm saying is there's no reason not to do the maze. You get some bombs, that's what those black things are, and I think there's some money somewhere. Possibly an extra life. I don't know what the question mark is. It's either money or an extra life. Or maybe the box is money. I don't know. We'll see when I get out. Alright. Need to go up here. I think that is money. And then left. More bombs. Okay, excellent. Okay, right now... Oops. I turned around. Let's see. Alright, cool. Okay, right now I have $632, and it doesn't show how many extra lives I have. Okay, so I got my $100 back from the box. That's good. And, it looks like I did get an extra life. Because PAL-02, and I also got some bombs. You can switch to those as well as the coins by using the R button. And I'm a little hurt, so I'll buy some food. See, I have half my health, so I'll buy the middle food item. Looks like some sort of ribs, possibly. It doesn't really say what they are. I think it's ribs, and then this is ramen noodles, and this is sushi. Wait, this is a Japanese-ass game to be a game that came out in the US not long ago. I mean, usually the super Japanese games like this, well, back then they didn't really get US releases. You want to play any games? Why, yes. Yes, I do. I want to play Mole, because you can make a crap ton of money doing this. You have two options, the slow course and the fast course. Basically, you want to do the slow course, because if you hit everything, you get a bonus of $300. And hitting everything is pretty much impossible in the fast course, at least for me. So, slow course is the way to go. I mean, in the fast course, if you don't hit everything and get the perfect bonus, you're gonna be lucky to make your money back. I usually can't do it, so I just stick to the slow course. Now see, when I first started doing this, I thought you didn't want to hit Dr. Yang when he pops up, because I thought it was like a negative or something. But no, you want to hit everything. Anything and everything that pops out of a hole. That's what she said. Okay, no, she didn't. That's gross. She said nothing of the sort. Did I get him? Yep. Perfect bonus. $300.83. Supposedly, you can get more money during the fast stage, but even hitting almost everything, but just missing a few like I usually do, I still don't make much more than $83. It's like in the high 80s or low 90s or something. Interesting that the unit of currency is the dollar. I mean, as Japanese as this game is, you'd think they'd just go ahead and use the yen. I guess they didn't want to confuse American audiences too much. So that's why it's dollars and raccoon dogs instead of yen and tanuki. Is the plural of tanuki still tanuki? I think that's how that works. Look at all those tanuki. Welcome. We have everything you need. Well, you don't have everything, but it's a good start. Okay, basically you want to stock up on sandals, because they make you faster, and every time you get hit, you lose one pair of sandals. I think you can only have three at a time, but I think you can hold another... Yeah, you can hold like another six or seven or so, for like a total of 10. Pizza revives you if you die. Without having to go back to the well, I don't know if you have to go back to the beginning normally, but it like maybe it revives you without having to lose a life or something. Anyway, it's a good idea to at least buy a few of those. I actually think 3 is the most pizza you can have. Yeah, the limit on straw sandals is 10. The limit on bombs is probably also 10. Wonder why it says I still have an elephant when I'm well past the 2D stage. I don't know. Maybe... See how much faster I am now? It's awesome. Maybe having the elephant outside of the 2D platformer stage signifies something else. I don't know. Okay, this is a trap. If you get your fortune told, there's going to be a shitload of enemies when you get out, so... Don't do that. I mean, I could do it just to show it off, but just imagine that guy with the pole, and then, like, you know... fucking 12 of them, and then that's what it's like. Alright, this is the travel agency, the Oedo travel agency, or Oedo, Shikoku Island, that's where that cat dude was. Now, there are three different paths you can choose. Basically, the only difference is, if you're hurt, buying a higher path will heal more of your health by the time you get there. So, since I'm full up, I'll just go with the basic pack. Oh wait, I have one life. The PAL O2 thing is something different. Maybe that's what the scrolls are. There's no tour guide with package A. I don't know why I'm using that voice for the girl, but... Oh, Dr. Yang. You think he would steer the shark away from Kid Ying. When something is wrong in Edo, action must be taken. Kid Ying and Dr. Yang leave for Shinkoku Island to meet Koban, the cat boss. Alright. I don't know what Warlock Zone 2 means. I also don't know if these are real places in Japan, or just locations that they're making up. You know, as much media as I consume from Japan, between video games, music, and, you know, the few animes I actually like, I really don't know that much about Japan. Something strange about the Hyotoku people at this year's festival. They're up to something. You should be careful. Yeah, thanks. I don't know who those people are. I don't know what's up with these weirdos in the masks. See, there's a travel agency. If I guess you want to go back, maybe you can save your game here or something. There are many Hyotoku people in town, so it's a very lively place. Maybe the mask people are Hyotoku. There's somewhere you can save the game that looks similar to the travel agency. But I won't worry about it. I always have save states, so if I end up having to cut it short. Which I shouldn't have to now that I can upload, you know, I can upload really any length of video I want to YouTube. Strange Lantern Man. Yeah, I don't care. Yeah, it's pretty cool. YouTube has really become, you know, the go-to. Oh, come on! The go-to, video upload site. I mean, back in the old days, YouTube was just like, the only reason to use it is because that's where everyone is. But now, I mean, YouTube really, you know, risen to the top. What with... Oops, I actually need my multiple straw coats, too. I don't actually know what these do. I just figure they're probably good to have. But yeah, YouTube surpassed, you know, Vimeo, Vidler, Google Video isn't a thing anymore. I know that used to be the preferred method of the Something Awful people. You know, they hate YouTube. Because of, well, because YouTube is the most popular. Oh, I hate this guy. Fuck. Because YouTube is the most popular, you know, anything that's popular is going to draw. Okay, stupid people are more vocal than loud people. So, oh shit. So, anything with a lot of people, you're going to notice a lot more stupid people because they're just so much louder than everyone else. You know, they post more and there's a lot of stupid people. How about some martial arts training? If you work hard, I'll teach you my jutsu. I don't know if that's like jujitsu or not. You'll only be allowed to use jutsu in this zone, but it will be very valuable to you. With your physical ability, you will not be able to master such a jutsu. You better not even try. Wow. Thanks, bro. Real boost to the old self-confidence there. One thing that you have to learn about this game is that enemies will pretty much constantly respawn even when you're just standing around. So, if your instinct, like me, is to kill everything on the screen before moving on, it's not going to happen because they're going to keep coming. Oh, here's a safe place. It looks just like the travel agency, just with a different person. I don't know how long I've been going, but I won't make this video too long. I don't want to bore you to tears. Oh, is there a password? What? I thought it actually saved it. You've kept a good diary. Well, thanks. Okay, well, in that case, I will save my state. And I'll keep going for a little while. You know, I have some alcohol in me, so I'm good to keep talking. It's so fucking hot in here though, because I turn the fan off when I start recording. Oh, it's this dude again. Yeah, I'll play some one more. Why not? Let me pour myself another delicious adult beverage. This will be my third one of the night. Probably won't do too many more. Yeah, this lady called in to Wait Wait Don't Tell Me, and she was in the adult beverage industry. And the cast was like, what's an adult beverage? And she was like, oh, beer, wine, liquor, you know, the obvious answer. Alright, bottoms up. Goes down smooth. Alright, let's whack some more moles. You know, I resent the fact that they call it a slow course. It's like whack-a-mole for retards. Oh wait, I forgot, I'm not supposed to say retards anymore. You know, let me rant on that for a little while. Because there is this, like, crusade. You know, I'm all for, you know, not using insulting language, like racial slurs, you know, homophobic language, you know, all that stuff. You know, I'm pretty much as liberal as they come. But I don't understand why there's a push to stop using the word retard. I mean, okay, it used to be offensive because retard and retarded used to be the actual scientific term for, you know, for that condition, for having a mental disability. It's not anymore. I mean, no... Oh, come on. I better buy some food. You know, no scientific paper... Oh, you don't have any food. Lame. No scientific paper is going to use the word retard or retarded when referring to somebody with a mental disability. Because, yeah, I don't care. Because language has changed. I mean, it's happened many, many times in the past. Words like idiot, moron, imbecile, all these used to be, you know, valid lottery. Yeah, I'll give it a shot. All those words used to be, like, valid scientific words for, you know, a mental disability. But over time, people started using them in a derogatory manner. Oh, cool. I think I won. I think I just lost $50. Oh, wait, no. No, I didn't win anything. Okay, there are more prizes. What did I pick? I forget. Yeah, I'm not gonna win anything. Oh, well. Oh, I did win $50. Okay, awesome. But, you know, nobody would be offended if somebody called somebody an idiot. Because idiot no longer means, you know, mentally challenged. I mean, that's not correct either anymore. You're not supposed to say it. I think it's like developmentally disabled or something like that. Now, I mean, of course, if you use idiot, moron, retard to refer to someone who's actually mentally disabled, then yeah, that's offensive because, you know, they were born with a disability. They shouldn't be, you know, insulted like that. But if you just use it in casual conversation with, you know, a person of normal intelligence, you know, just, man, you're such an idiot, or you're such a retard, that shouldn't be offensive because you're not talking about actual, you know, when I call somebody a retard, what springs to mind isn't a person with Down syndrome or something like that. It's just, you know, a person acting dumb. Just, you know. Anyway, that's my two cents on the matter. This is dangerous territory. I'm gonna rub my balls all over it. Oh yeah, it's this dude. So yeah, I'm gonna keep saying retard. If any of you are offended by it, just know that, you know, the English language evolves. I mean, idiot and moron are no longer, you know, offensive terms. They're just... Whoa. Oh, I have to hit the white ones first, that's right. Or the white ones, period. So yeah, if any of you are genuinely looking to buy it, then you know, I do apologize, but I'm not going to stop saying it. So there we go. All right, if I remember correctly, this boss. Oh, come on, drop down. That was bogus. This boss isn't really that hard either. All you have to do. Okay, now I think I can hit the red ones. Oops. Yeah. Whoa. Did I die and use a piece of pizza? Because I'm at higher health than I was. Maybe I found some health and I just didn't realize it. How am I doing on pizza, by the way? Oh, I guess I did die because I only have one slice left. That's unfortunate. Dudes in those balls look like Shy Guys. Or, Sniffits to be specific. Because they have those, like, gun barrel mouths. Oh, I'm out of pizza. That sucks. I just lost 3 pieces of pizza to this boss. And I was all like, oh yeah, this dude's easy. Meanwhile, I die 3 times without even realizing it. How many sandals do I have left? 4? Wow. Which means I've gotten hit 6 times since I bought sandals. That's sucky. A better weapon would really be helpful. Oh yeah, I do have coins, don't I? Let's try that. Take that! And that! These guys are going to spit some more fire. Man, they're spitting fire on this track! It's insane! I probably can't hit them when they're off the screen, but it's worth a shot. Man, I have a lot of money. Alright, now I just need to hit this guy in the head a few times, and it'll all be hunky-dory. Meh. I forget if he has any other attacks besides just jumping. Whoa! Alright, almost got him. Yes! Hey, Bulldog. Die. Oh, hey, it's Koban. Aww, he's a silly kitty. Meow, thanks for helping me out of there. I'm Koban Cat. Meow, I've been waiting for you. We're a band of ninja cats. Protecting Ito is our responsibility. Meow, can I have some milk? We're on a top secret mission. The precious Princess Yuki, the one and only daughter of the ruler of Ito, has been kidnapped. We've searched all over Japan, and now we think we know where she is. Not Japan. Oh no, it seems like she's been taken by a mysterious group of masked men. Hey, I've seen some masked men. These masked men have special weapons that cripple our ability to change forms. It's these special weapons of theirs that have caused us so much trouble. But we've learned something. Yarn is fucking fun to play with. No, I mean, the horrible Otafu army of Awaji Island have been known to kidnap women. They must have taken Princess Yuki. She has to be there. Please, we beg of you, save Princess Yuki, so she can give us treats, and pet us behind her ears. Hey, fireworks. Sweet. We're fucking heroes. Kid Yi and Dr. Yang encountered the Hyotoku army and did away with them. Now they must go to Awaji Island to take care of the Otafu army. Wicked kidnappers of helpless people. Warlock Zone 3. Amusement Park. Oh yeah, this place is fun. There's all kinds of stuff to play with here. Alright, I think that's pretty good for this video, so I'm gonna go on ahead and cut it here. My friend watching this, I hope you're able to load this in Iraq, and I hope it brought you a little bit of enjoyment in a hostile environment, and I hope, you know, that you can come back soon, because, you know, It sucks. Another video should be going up, hopefully, in a week or so. I'm going to try to record these more faithfully because, you know, there's actually someone, you know, requesting it. So, yeah, hopefully things will go a little smoother. All right, I'm Duke of the Bum. See you next time.